do with that yours?
That's not. But yeah.
Mm. Yeah.
Okay. Still water, really water, isn't it?
Yeah,
it up to the side. At every stage, I start to think, how can I replace the convention, that the kind of image-based convention, with a physical activity? So instead of making a line with a brush or with a pencil, I cut a line, and then I sew a line. So those are physical embodiments of the qualities that you find the paint. So a lot of what I do is about trying to find an equivalent to what we find in painting, but find a physical form for it.
Thank you.
was in a landscape, I was thinking carefully about what the experience, my experience of being in a landscape was. I wanted those things to be a model for what I wanted the experience of the paintings to be for the viewer. So it's that physicality, understanding of time, movement is really important. You know, these works, you don't stand in front of them, you don't fix yourself and do a turner or a traditional landscape. You move around, and that's a really important part of it. There's a kind of logic about the way you make the work, which has an implication in terms of the way you show it. Lengths of cloth I take out to the landscape work, and that kind of makes me think, well, that softness, and what happens when it's being softened in a landscape by the weather, should be something that's in the finished work. What happens to something while you're making it is a clue to the way it can be displayed and what qualities you should be after. That's taller, and the actual area of that is the same as that. It's all set up properly. So I was thinking about a balance in terms of area, and also the kind of relationship between the colours, which is something I've seen a lot around here. I mean, the idea being to play with these forms and to try and find a kind of a point of balance where there is a relationship to the colour and to the form, but having these different steps in for it. Put the whole thing together and then make a decision about whether I'll take some out later on. That's the plan. But at the moment, it's really nice because it's really dark inside, at least on here. Mm. Really, really dark inside there. Well, you know, kind of because I'm interested in the materials of painting, this stuff, canvas, cotton, is everywhere. It's everywhere. And we will paint on it and we will not really think about what it is, but I really want to think about what it is and how you can use it. It's not just a surface, it's something I'm interested in its own qualities and what it can do. I think what I'm trying to do is to try and find a way of rebalancing, recalibration. So I think maybe painting has gone really far in one direction, and I'm just trying to pull it back and try and make it more a complete sense of experience for a viewer rather than this full-on visual experience which is just about looking and just about images. As close to it as you possibly can, you don't need to touch it. If you touch it, you understand and you walk away. So it's like wanting certain things, but not wanting the inevitable logical conclusion to it. So you want the thing to be physical, but it needs to be physically answered in certain ways. And that's a strategy about when you make work, how you make things that take you to a certain point. It's only the very last thing you do that actually gives the form to the work. It just remains as material. Yeah. And only with the final so that it takes its form and becomes a thing that, you know, it's designed to be. It's only at that moment.